So let us try another practical example while animating a facial expression. So I'll be giving a small demonstration of how I use squash and stretch principle to kind of create a certain expression so that the animation looks believable and interesting. So I'm drawing a face. I'm trying to do a happy face. So I'll draw the first frame, which is a very kind of a basic ovalish face. So I finish the first frame. Now the second frame, which is my, I'm kind of going straight ahead right now, but as you see here, I'm doing a blink for the anticipation. So he's basically he blinks and then does the happy face expression. So quickly finishing this particular frame, I'll try to demonstrate how in the next frame, which is my squash frame, I change the shape but not the volume. So as you see here, I'm drawing the eyebrows down. I'm drawing, I'm squashing, as you see here, I'm squashing the entire facial volume and trying to create this anticipation action of how he's gonna get into this pose of stretch and then the final happy face. So he anticipates, as you see, I'm adding a squash. You'll exactly see in the end how the squash helps to get a certain believability and energy in the whole animation. So the next frame, the immediate next frame, is my stretch frame. So what I do is I kind of elongate certain areas, keeping my volumes in mind. So I kind of stretch the face. Now in this, it's going to be a bigger expression. I kind of elongate the ear, stretch it very slightly. There's not too much of stretch. It's a very minimal stretch, but I think this works for me. So I'm using stretch here. As you see, I'm drawing a bit elongated one. So I finish the drawing quickly. And I'll draw the hair. Yeah. So draw the hair in the previous frame also. And then I'll be coming back. So I kind of copy the previous frame and finish. It's a very minimal animation. It's like 4-frame animation. I'll play right now and see what happens. So as you see here, there's a certain charm, and this, by using squash and stretch, it looks much more interesting. And it's kind of surprise happy face, which I try to incorporate the principles in. So here I'll kind of leave you with this principle, how you can apply it. It's a final version here, as you can see. Thank you so much. Hope you enjoy the module. In the next video, we'll take a look at the next principle of animation, which is anticipation.